As we look at the future of our great club tonight, it's important to reflect on the early years and the history that has brought everyone together as part of the Cúchulainn family. Early records show that football was the dominant sport within the club until the 1940s, and early successes were on the footballing side, with the historic treble-winning side of 1924, 25 and 26. We won another three senior football titles in the 1930s. Between 1923 and 1941, our club contested 16 football finals, winning six senior and one junior title. Our Camogie club was founded in 1933 and in the following years would establish itself at the forefront of the Camogie scene in Antrim. The club dominated Camogie in the 40s and 50s, with five of their 11 championship wins coming during this period. Dunloy's success hadn't gone unnoticed, and the Antrim senior Camogie team that won an All-Ireland title in 1956 featured six Dunloy players, including a 14-year-old goalkeeper who is still the youngest player ever to win an All-Ireland senior medal. Hurling started to flourish in the club in the early 40s, and although two hurling finals were contested in the 30s, our club suffered defeat on both occasions by the narrowest of margins. During these lean years, many hard-fought battles were won with rivals near and far, and many great hurlers donned the green and gold of Dunloy. Over the years, Dunloy Club were blessed to watch players like John Robb, Aidan McCampbell and Willie Richmond, to name just a few. The progress off the pitch continued, and on the 21st of May 1950, Pierce Park was opened. At the time, our new facilities were held as an example to the rest of the clubs in the county, a mantle we are very proud to carry to this day. The late 60s saw further development of our facilities, with the first club rooms and changing facilities being built. Football in the club had some part of a revival in the 70s, winning the junior football title and the club's first ever Antrim intermediate football title. This feat was repeated 31 years later, going one step further and getting to an Ulster final in 2007. Great players graced both teams, showing that the club could compete at a high level in both codes. There was also a huge resurgence coming in hurling in the 80s, as it became evident that the great work being put into coaching at underage level, along with the investment in our facilities, was starting to bear fruit. With the golden generation of hurlers coming through the underage ranks, winning championships at every age level. In 1984, we won every championship in hurling from under 14 through to under 21, a record that is still standing to this day. However, it was five under 21 hurling titles between 1984 and 1990 that became the springboard for the historic breakthrough success at senior level in 1990. The celebrations and the sense of relief following the historic win in 1990 saw the whole parish come together to celebrate. Our club would continue to try and celebrate every championship win with the same enthusiasm and vigour, but nothing could match the euphoria of 1990. 1990 was the catalyst that started a run which saw the club win 12 senior hurling championships, 10 Ulster hurling titles, and 4 All-Ireland appearances during this glorious period. It has been reported that this generation of hurlers were among the best never to have won the Tommy Moore Cup. Progress off the pitch continued to emulate the success on it with the development of a second pitch in 1994 and the opening of new changing facilities, club rooms and social centre. Not to be outdone, our Camogiers won 4 senior titles during the glorious 90s, including an Ulster title in 1994 and making it all the way to an All-Ireland semi-final, emulating the great teams of the 50s, and set the standard for which Camogie teams would be measured against. Another Ulster final win in 2003 by our Camogiers extended the dynasty created by players like Anne McKee, Nigella McMullen and Una Elliott. The club was winning on all fronts and the hard work off the field was paying huge dividends now on the field. Whilst the success in hurling continued to 2009, the club had already been laying foundations for future success when a steering committee was formed to ensure the continued development of facilities producing the next generation of heroes. It was to be our club's most ambitious project to date, and especially in a financially unstable environment. But not to be put off, the steering committee embarked upon the project to secure funding and build the Lois Swartz Academy in 2010. It was to be the jewel in the crown and the envy of compatriots near and far. This foresight has proved to be correct with some notable successes since the investment in the Sports Academy. This new generation of players was raised on a diet of ball walls and a quick touch, sharpened in the cosy confines of the new Sports Academy. Although success on the pitch is important, Dunloy as a club have always felt an intricate part of the wider community. And back in 2014, set upon a path to encourage health and well-being amongst members and friends. This started out with launching of Operation Transformation, which has run for 4 years now, and has kick-started a healthier lifestyle for hundreds of people in the village. Part of our reason for doing this was also to improve the mental well-being of our members, and we have held various talks and events around this theme, including a dawn walk last year in aid of mental health charity Zest NI. Make sure you continue to support our great club, and I hope you and your families continue to enjoy the success and joy that comes with being part of the Cúchulainn family.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. A lonely place to be. And so I learned to depend on me. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadows. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest love of all is happening to me. I found the greatest love of all inside of me. The greatest love of all is easy to achieve. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let thy children's love